Welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to be sharing with you my favorites for August. I don't know about you guys, but this year is going by so fast. I can't hardly believe it myself. It's really crazy. Before you know it, it'll be Thanksgiving, it'll be Christmas, and then it'll be New Year's. I don't know what to do. I really don't. I think the older you get, the faster the time seems to go by. I don't know if that's just me or anyone else, but I feel like this year is just going by way too fast. Like I said, I'm going to be sharing my monthly favorites, month of August, for you guys, and just to show you what I've been using this month. And I mainly, when I pick my favorites, I tend to pick products that I keep going back to, and I keep, you know, doing the same type of looks or trying something different. And I have done everything from primer all the way to like brows. And I try to start at the beginning of my makeup routine and then to the end. I don't know if you guys noticed, but for those of you that have been on YouTube with me for a while, I had a horde of teddy bears back there. Completely gone. I got rid of them, and not because I didn't love them. I loved every single one of them, but it was just taking up way too much space, and they collect dust like crazy. So I did like a little bit of a spring cleaning, even though I have like multiple spring cleanings a year, but I did a little bit of a spring cleaning and just put them all in a bag and donated them, whatever. I was just like, I'm getting rid of them. No more hoard of stuffed animals. Plus, it was a pain to like shove them all to the side at night because I only sleep on one side of my bed, and then it was time to get rid of them. With my teddy bears being gone though, it sets this up a little bit nicer. I like doing a background like this because it feels a little bit more like at home and more comfortable, and I don't know, I don't worry too much about the fancy backdrop or anything like that. I just want to make sure it's clean. That way you guys can, you know, at least feel like you're with, you know, at home with me, and we're just chilling and talking about makeup, right? Because that's what I love here about YouTube, is that you can just chill and talk about makeup, and, you know, that's just how I roll. I like that. Okay, on to my favorites. I'm done babbling, so time to get to what you really clicked on this video for, was to know what my monthly favorites are for this month. Starting with primer, my first favorite is the NYX Angel Veil Skin Perfecting Primer. I don't know if you guys can see it very well or something. The lighting is just super weird. Oh, there we go. So it's the Angel Veil Skin Perfecting Primer. It is amazing. It really is. I tend to place it more in my T-zone area, so like underneath my eyes here, down the bridge of my nose, middle of my forehead, and especially my chin. This is where I tend to collect a lot of oil throughout the day, and this just leaves your skin velvety, angel smooth. Excuse me. It just leaves your skin angel velvety smooth. Like, it really does. And I notice a difference when I put my concealer on, that when I have it underneath and when I don't. So I don't know, I think it's just me. I don't know if anyone else has experienced this, but like my makeup doesn't fall apart as much. I guess it's just me, but it does just give a nice finish when you are done putting on your makeup. So this is my, like, definitely my favorite. I think this is my second purchase of the Angel Veil Perfecting Primer. So, and it's very inexpensive too. I mean, you get 1.2 fluid ounces, or 1.02 rather, and it's about $14-$15 at like CVS, Target. So, I mean, yeah, it's still quite a bit, but it's better than like $30. Okay, so it's on the foundation, and I don't know if you guys can guess what my favorite is. I don't know. It's kind of a hard decision. So hard. Not really. My Derma Blend, for sure. I dare to say, my holy grail foundation. And I'm gonna label it as that. This is like my ride or die foundation, at least for me, because I have troubled skin, because I get breakouts, because I have blemishes and scarring. This has been the only foundation, other than Bare Minerals, that has not broken me out. And I am very, very scared and just very timid to trying just any foundation, like, you know, L'Oreal, Maybelline foundations or Rimmel London. Like, I am so, like, scared to try it because I'm afraid that I'm gonna pay this money and then all it's gonna do is break me out. It's when I go to Sephora and I see, like, the Becca foundations and I see the Tarte foundations, Kat Von D, and I'm like, I'm so close to getting it to try it, but then in the end, I'm like, am I gonna waste my money? Because is it just going to break me out? So after a ton of research, and trust me, I do my research before I purchase any sort of, like, makeup item, especially when it's foundation, I did my research and I kept coming back to Dermablend. I kept coming back to it, and it was like it was meant to be. So I went to Ulta because they only sell this at Ulta. I think Sephora sells it too, but only like specific places, and the locations I've been to, they don't have it. So, but Ulta for sure had it like right away, and I was able to find it. And it's the Smooth Liquid Camo, and it's medium coverage foundation. It also has SPF 25. It has SPF 25 in it. It's a thick foundation, which means that you don't need a lot of product for it to go a long way. You really don't. And you don't have to layer so much to get the coverage that you want, which is perfect for me because I love the Bare Minerals foundation. I really do. The liquid one, and it's water-based, and there are no, you know, random chemicals that will make me break out or clog my pores. I love it for that. But it was a very, very sheer foundation, and I noticed that I had to layer it and layer it and layer it just so I can get the coverage that I wanted. But the more I layered, the cakier it looked, and then the more it transferred throughout the day. So when I found Dermablend and I tried it the first time, it was like an instant like notability. Like, it really was. Like, even my fiance David was like, you tried the new foundation. It looks like you had no scarring ever at all on your face at all. So definitely this is my holy grail, ride or die. I will definitely repurchase this a million times throughout my whole life. Go with it. I also would purchase the Dermablend Leg and Body Cover. This is a nice little bang for your buck, okay? So it's 3.4 fluid ounces, and I purchased this one on a sale. Dermablend was 50% off, and I took advantage of it. It was $15 with the 50% off, $15 or $16. And I loved it because all you need is just a little bit. I use it for concealer right underneath the foundation. And I apply just a very, very thin layer with my beauty sponge, and I blend it all out just to get that nice full coverage that I want without having to pack on and pack it on. I will tell you though, it took me a while to really figure out how to play with this foundation because it's thick and because you don't need a lot. When I first started using it, I applied a little too much, and then you find that it cakes up and it creases. And at first I was like a little disappointed, but then I'm like, you know what? Let me try something different. So I tried new techniques. I tried using my beauty sponge and then applying with a synthetic brush and then putting the beauty sponge again over top just to soak up any excess makeup. And it really leaves me with a nice finish. And I'm very happy with this. And a lot of people get tripped up because it says leg and body. So it's actually meant to cover like tattoos and body scarring, but I figured if it covers body scarring, why wouldn't it cover the scarring on my face? So I purchased it, and it'll last me a very, very long time. And I use this every day, and I still have this pretty much full. So these two together are like my ride or die products. If you hear any screaming, I don't know if you can hear them. Okay, so my brother is playing video games and on his Xbox One, and he tends to like yell at the TV or at his friends or whoever he's talking to. Okay, I'm gonna go with setting powder and just like an overall face powder, not an under eye powder, because I think I've already mentioned my under eye powder in another video. I'm not entirely sure, but I just wanted to play it on the safe side. If I didn't, then I will mention it next month then, because I recently just repurchased my under eye powder. But I wanted to give a shout out to my face powder. This is a mineral powder. I look for anything that says mineral, that says all natural, organic, anything that are those, like, those key words, I am directly attracted to it. So because of my skin history and because of my face, I want to be as, like, watchful as possible with what I put on my face. So I have the NYX Mineral Set It, Don't Fret It setting powder, and it's a matte finishing powder, and it's in the shade medium dark. I was going to pick up light medium, but it looked way too light for my skin tone, at least. So I picked up this one, and I just use this to set my face powder, and it's amazing. It really does mattify. It really does, you know, make you look like you have this nice smooth finish to your face. It really does. So this is something I will definitely repurchase. I think I'm getting close, as if I can see. I'm getting close to having to repurchase this, but I definitely will. And it's one of my favorites for this month. It really has. I keep going back to it. I've used it, I believe, all last month as well. So I figured, why not put it into this video? For contouring, I don't really contour that much. I more like to bronze my face just to give it a nice sun-kissed look. And the bronzer I've been going for is the Wet n Wild Contouring Palette. And they recently changed their formula, and it is really, really nice. I picked up the shade, if it says it on here, Dulce de Leche. And it is really, really pretty. It comes with a highlighting powder and a contouring powder. I don't know if you can see that well. Okay. Comes with a highlighting powder and a contouring powder. As you can see, I've already hit pan on it. I use it pretty much every day, and it really gives a nice look to the skin. It really makes it look nice and healthy, and that's what I love about this. And I don't use a lot, just enough on, you know, the side of my cheeks here and my forehead and my jawline, just to really define those areas. And I keep going back to this one. I'm probably gonna have to repurchase this because I hit pan on it. I have to tell them to keep it down, because it's so hard to, like, do this, and I don't want to have to refilm everything. Boys and their video games. But I love video games too, but I just don't scream like that. For my highlight, it really comes as no surprise, because this has been my favorite highlight for the past month, I have to say. Yeah, for the past month, I got this either on my birthday or extremely close to my birthday. My fiance got me the Jaclyn Hill and Becca Cosmetics collaboration of Champagne Pop. And I know I'm so late. I'm so late, guys. It's called, I didn't have any money to buy it when it came out. I didn't have 30, almost 38, almost 40 bucks to spend. But then when my birthday came around, he knew I'd been eyeing this for a long time. I had swatched it so many times in Sephora. I had tried it on, and I left there, like, a little sad because I couldn't get it. Either I was short and strapped for cash or paying bills, you know. Just, you know, that's just how it is. I was coming out of college, so, you know, I couldn't really afford much. So he finally got it for me for my birthday, and I was so happy. And you've seen it swatched a million times, so I don't need to swatch it for you, but I just want to let you know that is my favorite. I've been using this non-stop for at least a month. Okay, so for the eyes, I have three eyeshadow palettes for you and two single eyeshadows. I've been experimenting a lot with just different looks, like this look I have here. I know it's a little hard to tell because of the camera setting, but it's like a blue, emerald, a little bit of purple. So before summer started, which is pretty recent, I did like a little bit of a haul, like a little mini haul from BH Cosmetics, and I just love BH Cosmetics, guys. Like, if you haven't tried it, you really need to. They're so inexpensive, and their quality is top notch, and they're just amazing. They're an amazing brand, and they have amazing products. Really is. So I purchased three palettes from them, and they're small palettes, and it's from their Wild collection. So each palette has like Wild and Free or Wild at Heart, you know, just has Wild in it. And I just love the packaging. Here's Wild and Free, and I love the packaging for this one. And it comes in a set of 9 eyeshadows, and these are just absolutely gorgeous. I'm wearing this shade on my eyes right now, along with another eyeshadow. And there's blue, there's purple, purple, there's greens, there's browns, and they're baked eyeshadows, and they're shimmer eyeshadows. And I just loved it. They're to die for. So this has been a really nice palette. I've been using pretty much all of the shades in here in one way or another. Another Wild palette is Wild Child, and this one has such cute packaging as well. And I love the packaging because it's like that magnetic packaging. And the shades in here are just absolutely gorgeous. I hate the lighting. Really do. So here we have like a dark brown, like purple. We have some pinks. We have a lot of neutrals in here. I think this is my mom's favorite palette is Wild Child. This is her favorite. She gets all of her neutrals from here. She borrows my makeup sometimes or has me do her makeup. And I just absolutely love it. The last one is Wild at Heart. This one has some pretty bold colors in it, like bam. So you have like this really dark gray, bright pink. You have another pink tone shade, peachy pink here. And you have gold and more browns. Like they all have like their own different personality. Like one's more neutral. The first one, which is Wild and Free, had more like greens and blues and purples. This one has like pinks and purples and grays. And I just love it. Like, and each one I believe was like $6, which is not bad for 9 baked eyeshadows. You need to go over and visit bhcosmetics.com. It really is. Like, their brushes are amazing, their products are amazing. I'm actually gonna be looking to see if they have any sales or deals going on, because the best time to buy from BH Cosmetics, even though they're fairly inexpensive as it is, but sometimes the best time to buy is when they throw their free shipping over, you know, $15 or more, or $25 or more. So then you can kind of like rack up products and then make it to just like the $15 or the $25, and you automatically get free shipping. So it's like you save money. Another thing is that they throw like BOGO deals, or they have like a code that you can put in for like a free brush set or free palettes. And it's really, really awesome. Last two eyeshadows, they are single eyeshadows, and they are the Maybelline color tattoos. This one is like they're cream eyeshadows. I have 3 color tattoos, but they're pigments. This one, I found it very intriguing that it was just a cream. And this one is in the shade Tenacious Teal, which is a nice bright blue. I'm wearing on my eyes currently is, I believe it's called Edgy Emerald. Yeah, Edgy Emerald. And this one's super, super cute as well. It's more of like a like turquoise, but because it has a little bit more green in it. And of course, like, these are a little bit more pricey for the single ones. They're like about $5 or $6 each shadow, but I rarely use them. I only use them whenever I want to, you know, wear something really colorful. So they last a real long time though, because you don't need a lot of product. Like, I've used this several times, and I'm still good on product. For the lips, I just have one favorite. Like, I keep going back to this one, and it's another birthday gift, and this is the Kat Von D Lolita 2. I love it. I absolutely love this lip gloss, liquid lip, whatever you call it. It lasts all day. It's matte. It's beautiful. Absolutely love this shade. I wore it today. I ate dinner and I had it on all day, so it's a little bit off, but still, the color is still pretty much like on there, even after an entire day. I love, love, love this one. And the color is just, look at it. It goes with pretty much any sort of eye look, especially when I do an eye look like this and I need something neutral. It's perfect. I also have a second one that I haven't tried yet. I'm waiting till the fall to try it. And it's Echo. It's a dark blue, and I loved it. I loved it so much. I tried it on at the store and I was like, ooh, this is so different. It's so edgy. I love it. And I'm just waiting till the fall, because for me, like, dark lips, I like wearing them in the fall. That's just me. You can rock a dark lip at any time of the year, but personally, I love the dark lips in the fall and winter time. I don't know, there's something about it that I'm just like, I love it. And I love wearing the dark lips, and it's like, for me, it's like a fall and winter thing. I don't know. I'm just weird, I guess. So I have my last two products, and they are brow products. I know. I never would have thought that I would mention brow products because I was always the type of person that was like, no, I don't need to fill my brows. My brows are fine. You know, they're pretty thick. They're thicker than other people that I've seen. And then I went to Sephora. Sephora is just like the darnest place. Like, I don't know. Like, I need to stay away. And I was so against like Sephora and Ulta, like in the beginning of my channel. I'm like, no, we can have beauty on a budget. And yes, I still do that. I am very like budget conscious when I buy. But now I've taken like one visit to Sephora and I see all the nice stuff. And then I see, and then I take a second visit to Sephora and then a third and then a fourth and then a fifth and then a sixth and this. And then it just, it's this cycle that I just keep going in. Even if it's just a look, I just keep going in. So one day I went into Sephora and there was a crew there for the for Benefit when they came out with their new brow products. And I was like, oh, I've never filled in my brows before. And one of the workers asked me like, oh, do you use like, you know, brow products? I'm like, no, I don't. I have brow gel, like the tinted brow gel. And they're like, oh, well, you should try some of our products. And I'm like, I don't know how to use them. I was just that honest. I'm like, I have never filled in my brows before. I don't know what to do. Like, how do I go about doing that? So one of the workers sat me down. He explained to me basically like the process of just filling in your brows and how easy it actually was. And he hi, my love. So anyway, right away he recommended the Cabrow by Benefit, and it is a cream gel brow. Basically, this little guy up here pops off, and it's like the angled brush, and then you open it here, and then you have a little, like, it's like a pomade. And you dip it and you like start, you know, filling in your eyebrows. And right after he was done, I was like, ooh. After he was done, I was like, oh, I'm so in love with my eyebrows right now. Not that I actually did that, but I was like surprised on how nice and thick and beautiful my eyebrows looked. So I told him that I had the Gimme Brow. I had bought this one first because I was not going to buy a brow pencil or a brow gel that I didn't know how to use. So I bought this one first and I told him, well, I already have the Gimme Brow. He's like, okay, you can just put that right over top and it will keep your hairs in place. It will fill in any missing areas. And I use both of these together and I absolutely love it. I have to fill in my eyebrows every single day now, unless I'm going to like the beach or the pool, or unless I'm working out or something, because I can't like not fill in my eyebrows. It's just so weird. Before I was like, I don't need to fill in my eyebrows. Like, I got some good eyebrows. And then now I'm like, oh my goodness, like I need to fill in my eyebrows. I really do. They look so much nicer and fuller and just more in place, and I love it. I didn't realize how much I really needed on my eyebrows for them to feel like they're actually full. So these are my two favorites for this month because I can't stop using them every single day. All right, and that is it for my monthly favorites of August. So my August monthly favorites, that is it. If you liked any of these products, or you're planning on using any of these products, or you have some products that are your favorites, then leave me a comment down below. Do not forget to comment, because I love talking with you guys. I love interacting, and I love this community, and I want us to stay in contact and keep in touch. If you have any suggestions, any feedback, please let me know, and I will talk to you guys soon. So don't forget to like and subscribe if you haven't already. I love you guys, and I will see you in my next video. Bye.